This is a single potassium atom and a single chlorine atom. Potassium has 19 electrons, with one electron in the valence shell. In order to reach the same number of electrons as the noble gas argon, potassium has to give up one electron. Chlorine has 17 electrons, of which 7 are in the valence shell. Chlorine has to take up one additional electron to have the same stable status as argon. If both atoms are close to each other, an electron transfer occurs. Potassium, which readily gives up electrons, transfers the single electron in its outer shell to chlorine. Chlorine readily accepts the single electron coming from potassium. Both atoms now have 8 electrons in their valence shell and therefore have reached a noble gas-like electron configuration. Since potassium lost one electron, it becomes positively charged. Chlorine has gained one electron and becomes negatively charged. The ionic bond is formed between potassium and chlorine by the electrostatic attraction between the opposite charges. Together, they are electrically neutral. When ions of opposite charges meet and form ionic bonds, they are held together by electrostatic forces. Atoms can also form chemical bonds by sharing electrons equally between each other. This is the case for covalent bonds, for example between two chlorine atoms. Both chlorine atoms need to acquire one additional electron to fill their valence shell to 8 electrons. By sharing two electrons, each chlorine atom has 8 electrons some of the time to fill the octet in their valence shell. Shared electrons move in between the valence shells of both atoms. The strong attraction of each shared electron to both atomic nuclei stabilizes the system and establishes a strong covalent bond between both chlorine atoms. In summary, in ionic bonds, such as those of KCl, atoms of opposite charge are held together by electrostatic forces. Electrons are shared by two atoms in covalent bonds, as for example in Cl2.